So the question is, what is Ubuntu and what does Ubuntu mean to me? I guess everyone will have their own personal definition of Ubuntu and how they've experienced it in their lives and in their communities and historically. The thing is that Ubuntu is not a unique African concept. It's a global concept that has been used by ancient civilizations all over the world. In Africa, we call it Ubuntu. And it seems that it's become a global expression now. So it's very exciting that Africa seems to be birthing not just the human race, but also a philosophy of unity within community. And ultimately, that's what it means to me. Ubuntu is the simplest expression of unity within community, where people work together, they cooperate for the greatest benefit of all the people within their community. And that's in essence what we're doing here in Waterval-Boerfen, at the home of Ubuntu, the Stone Circle Village and the Ubuntu Village. I ended up here because of my research into origins of humankind and ancient civilizations, and I found that we are sitting right in the heart of the largest vanished civilization complex ever discovered on planet Earth so far up to date. And that brought me here, first doing research into the stone circles and into Adam's calendar that has now become well known around the world and is growing in awareness all the time. But that led to a deeper understanding of what this place means to humanity and how it connects us to our origins as a species and what we can learn from all this knowledge of ancient civilizations. And that's really where I discovered about 10 years ago in 2005, I discovered that there was a time in human history that money did not exist, that people lived in united communities working towards the benefit of everyone in their community. And somehow that got corrupted. And that's when I started promoting this philosophy of Ubuntu in a modern society, or Ubuntu in the world of the 21st century. How can we apply this philosophy to the world today? And I came up with a concept called contributionism. Now, some people jump to the conclusion that it's like communism or socialism or whatever, or self-sustaining communities, and they'd all be wrong. Contributionism is very unique because it means creating abundance within communities, so much abundance by working together, by working in unity and cooperating as opposed to competing. So through this cooperation, creating so much abundance within your community that you can make your goods and produce available to all your surrounding and neighboring communities, and not just worrying about yourself, because self-sustaining communities are not really a solution for the future of humanity. Self-sustaining communities is more looking at yourself as a selfish individual. It's all about me, me, me. Now you're extending it to us, us, us. That's what a self-sustaining community is all about. Contributionism goes way beyond that. It creates abundance within your community, within your Ubuntu community, allowing you to make all your goods and services and produce and food, whatever it is you do, available to all your neighboring communities and anyone that comes to you as a community. So that is a unique approach and something that's never been done on this planet. And that's why what we are doing here is so unique and so difficult at the same time, because what we're doing is we're doing away with money. We're slowly, step by step, moving away from the use of money as a tool of exchange and a tool of control. For those that will watch this and that have done their research will understand that money is the ultimate tool of control, and that money is controlled by a small socio-political global elite who have taken control of our planet and used this, their right to create money and use money to control the rest of humanity. We are breaking that cycle. For the first time in probably 6,000 years or more, we are breaking that cycle of human abuse, control of humanity by a small global elite, and showing people that it's not only possible, but it is our right and actual, the natural way, the natural order of things, for people to create abundance beyond their wildest belief by simply working together. So in essence, that's what this is. It's been an interesting journey of discovery. We have volunteers coming here from all over the world, helping us strengthen and stabilize the Ubuntu Village, or the head office, or the headquarters of the Ubuntu movement. And the exciting thing is that The kind of bright minds and researchers and scientists that we've been meeting on our travels around the world while we're spreading the philosophy of contributionism, these people are sharing their discoveries and their tools with us, tools that can provide free and alternative source of electricity, healing and curing of all disease, providing solutions to every single problem we have as the human race. It's very exciting to be part of this seedling project that has never been done before, and this is why it's very difficult, but at the same time it's very easy because we've already started walking this path. We're not just talking about it, we're actually doing it. It's not going to be easy, but it doesn't mean it's going to have to take a long time. It means that we have to go through the process step by step, every day take another step forward. And we're already in this process. Very exciting times. If you're interested, join us here in Waterfallbuerfen. Come participate in this amazing new way forward, an experiment that's never been done before. And something that is growing around the world. The Ubuntu movement has members in more than 215 countries. For the first time, creating a global movement of consciousness that goes across borders, beyond restrictions, that speaks with the same unity consciousness voice, that crosses all boundaries and restrictions on humans on this planet. It belongs to the human race. So I truly see the Ubuntu contributionism movement as a bright light at the dark, gloomy tunnel of human misery and human enslavement that is waking people up and giving people real hope for the first time in a long, long time. Real hope and true hope and an understanding that there is a solution to our problem, and the solution is really, really simple. That solution is cooperation, working together for a greater benefit of all the people in our community. I hope this makes sense to you.